world today is clearly being tossed around by all the deceptions that are out there. There is chaos that has sprung up in diverse places. Wars and rumors of wars are everywhere as the Vatican's agenda presses forward with the kings of the earth to fulfill the last bit of prophecy that exists. Pestilences are coming from every direction with the storm of trouble that most are encountering in their lives as well. Trials of all kinds, temptations that are so overpowering that many are falling to the bewitching power of Satan and sinking into the sand of despair, while other Christians who are learning about Jesus for the first time are being killed for their new faith. The professed Christian world is being played like a fiddle because they are no longer listening to sound doctrine, but they have proven to love and enjoy the tunes of lies instead, which spew from the false prophets of the Protestant world and the alike who hold to the teachings of the papacy, who once slaughtered millions of Bible-believing Christians for not bowing to the Pope's agenda. Their agenda continues to press forward today as they round up as many as they possibly can under their false teachings. Those who understand the truth can see how most of the pulpits in the world today are filled with false teachers and their false doctrines and false prophets that come with their false prophecies, which Christ had warned us about these things.
And many false prophets shall rise and shall deceive many. For the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine, but after their own lusts shall they heap to themselves teachers, having itching ears. And they shall turn away their ears from the truth, and shall be turned unto fables.
Clearly these false ones who are leading the masses astray have entangled the world on the broad road to destruction.
Enter ye in at the strait gate, for wide is the gate, and broad is the way that leadeth to destruction, and many there be which go in thereat.
And one of these fables that are soon to ensnare so many people in the world today, particularly in the Christian world, is the rapture theory. There are many different rapture theories that are being presented to the world, which is setting up the Christian world for a massive fall in the future. When they will find out that they are not raptured out, it will discourage them to the point they will either just give up and walk away or not endure the test of the time of trouble, or the tribulation hour, as many know it to be. That tribulation is actually a time period which God will allow to test every soul on the planet that is alive during that time to see what they have built their life upon. The true and the false will be revealed in that hour. Many are even proclaiming that the rapture is going to be a silent one for the Christian, which is not biblical sound doctrine at all. These lies will be exposed with biblical truth as the Word of God reveals it. Many of you may now be even asking, is there even a rapture to begin with? Yes, there is going to be a rapture for a people, but for what people? How is it going to happen and when? Those are the questions that will be answered from the Word of God. The Apostle Paul reveals that the coming of Christ to this earth will be as follows.
For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord. Behold, I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trump. For the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed.
So the Apostle Paul declared that when Christ should come, there would be a shout, a voice, a trumpet, the righteous dead would be resurrected, and along with the righteous living, would be caught up from the earth to meet the Lord in the clouds, never more to part again. And the Apostle John reveals that the coming of Jesus to this earth will be as follows.
Behold, he cometh with clouds, and every eye shall see him, and they also which pierced him, and all kindreds of the earth shall wail because of him.
Here we can see that John declared that when Christ should come, it would be with clouds, and every eye on earth would miraculously see him, and all the kindreds of the earth who have rejected him would wail. Even the patriarch David reveals that the coming of Jesus Christ to this earth will be as follows.
Our God shall come and shall not keep silence. A fire shall devour before him, and it shall be very tempestuous round about him. He shall call to the heavens from above and to the earth, that he may judge his people. Gather my saints together unto me, those that have made a covenant with me by sacrifice.
So David declared that when Christ should come, it would not be in silence, but would be a time of judgment, with fire burning up and devouring those judged unworthy. And God would gather his saints from the ends of the earth with him, being those who have sacrificed all to follow Christ in obedience to him. The prophet Jeremiah reveals that the coming of the Lord to this earth will be as follows.
Therefore prophesy thou against them all these words, and say unto them, The Lord shall roar from on high, and utter his voice from his holy habitation. He shall mightily roar upon his habitation. He shall give a shout as they that tread the grapes against all the inhabitants of the earth. A noise shall come even to the ends of the earth, for the Lord hath a controversy with the nations. He will plead with all flesh. He will give them that are wicked to the sword, saith the Lord. The slain of the Lord shall be at that day from one end of the earth even unto the other end of the earth.
So we can see that Jeremiah declared that when Christ comes, he would mightily utter his voice, a shout would be given, it would be a noise throughout the whole earth that everyone would hear, and the Lord would plead with or judge all the people, and all the wicked would be slain. And Christ himself even reveals what his coming to this earth will be like.
And then shall appear the sign of the Son of Man in heaven. And then shall all the tribes of the earth mourn, and they shall see the Son of Man coming in the clouds of heaven with power and great glory. And he shall send his angels with a great sound of a trumpet, and they shall gather together his elect from the four winds, from one end of heaven to the other.
Christ clearly declared that when he returns the second time, it would be with a sign. All on the earth would see him coming in the clouds of heaven, and with power and great glory. The great majority of all the people of the earth would not be happy, but would mourn, and there would be a great sound of a trumpet, and God would gather his obedient elect to himself from every part of the world. The scriptures are a light unto our feet. It is a word of truth. It does not err. It does not lie. The word of God tells us what it will be like when Christ comes back to this earth in the last days. There will be great signs that will occur just prior to his arrival. Everyone on the earth, every person of every nation and tribe will see his return in great power and great glory. And there will be a great noise and a shout, a heavenly voice, and of a great loud trumpet will sound. The righteous dead will be resurrected from their graves, and together with the living righteous at that time, the commandment-keeping saints of God will be caught up into the air to meet the Lord in the clouds, because they chose to sacrifice all to obey their God upon a wicked world. And while that is going on, the rest of the earth, the inhabitants of it, will be burned up by the glory and brightness of the Lord's consuming fire at his coming, because they chose not to obey Christ in keeping his commandments, which expresses perfect love. But they preferred the side of the wicked, rebellious ones, the way of Satan, and thus they are judged worthy of everlasting death. And so, as we have heard from around the world, this doctrine on the silent rapture or secret rapture, it is nowhere to be found in the Word of God, because when Christ returns to earth, it will be visible for all to see and for all to hear. Now, what about those scriptures which declares that the Lord will come as a thief in the night? Surely this would back up a belief of a secret rapture, right? Well, the Apostle Paul tells us,
but the heavens and the earth, which are now, by the same word, are kept in store, reserved unto fire against the day of judgment and perdition of ungodly men. The Lord is long-suffering to usward, not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance. But the day of the Lord will come as a thief in the night, in the which the heavens shall pass away with a great noise, and the elements shall melt with fervent heat, the earth also, and the works that are therein shall be burned up.
Peter declared in harmony with the rest of Scripture that when Christ returns, it would be with great noise and fervent heat which melts and burns up the earth. There is definitely nothing silent or secret about the rapture. It should then be obvious that the phrase of Christ coming as a thief in the night does not have reference to a secret rapture, but to individuals being surprised or caught off guard and unprepared for that day and hour. And so, some would say, but what about those scriptures which talk of one being taken and the other being left behind? Surely that supports the belief of a secret rapture, doesn't it? No, it does not. In this scripture, Christ was drawing the parallel between the time of his coming and the time of Noah and the flood. And there certainly was nothing secret about the flood, now was there? Christ has given everyone throughout every generation a probationary time period to get right with him while we are in the hour of his grace as well, before Revelation chapter 22 verse 11 is pronounced. It will surely be as a thief in the night for those who are unprepared. It will surely also be a fearful thing to fall into the hands of the living God, just as it was for those who did not enter into the ark after being warned of the coming storm. There were those who were taken into the ark and saved, and there were those who were left behind, who disobeyed God and would not listen to his warnings, just as it will be done in the last days. And others may ask, well, what about the belief that Christ would rapture all his people off the earth before the time of trouble, or the tribulation period, or the hour of persecution, and the working of Satan with all signs and lying wonders? What does the Bible have to say about this? The prophet Daniel declared,
"And there shall be a time of trouble such as never was since there was a nation, even to that same time."
And the apostle John declared that God's righteous people who were living when Christ returns to this earth would be those.
"These are they which came out of great tribulation and have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb."
And the apostle Paul reveals the timing of Christ's coming as follows.
"And then shall that wicked be revealed, whom the Lord shall consume with the spirit of his mouth and shall destroy with the brightness of his coming, even him whose coming is after the workings of Satan, with all power and signs and lying wonders, and with all deceivableness of unrighteousness in them that perish, because they received not the love of the truth, that they might be saved. And for this cause God shall send them strong delusion, that they should believe a lie, that they all might be damned who believed not the truth, but had pleasure in unrighteousness."
And so Daniel and John and Paul plainly declared that the coming of Christ and the deliverance of God's faithful saints cannot take place until after the great tribulation, until after the time of trouble, and after the working of Satan with all power and signs and lying wonders, which will take place in the hour when Satan appears soon, pretending to be Christ. This pretender will be received by the world as he has long been grooming them in the ways of unrighteousness, which is lawlessness, and it is sinning against God by breaking his commandments. And then all these that would give themselves over to Satan through his deceptions will suffer the results in the seven last plagues, and then ultimately be destroyed with the brightness of Christ's true second coming. As we can biblically see and hear, There will be no rapture for God's people to take them out of the storm that is coming. All will have to walk through it and prepare for it now is our calling, by becoming more Christ-like in all things, which we can do by reforming our lives of unrighteousness and departing from it and perfecting the law of righteousness before probation closes on this world and God's grace runs out. The next time anyone sees the Son of God, it will have been too late to repent as it was for Satan in heaven. Probation will close as Revelation chapter 22 verse 11 proclaims.
He that is unjust, let him be unjust still. And he which is filthy, let him be filthy still. And he that is righteous, let him be righteous still. And he that is holy, let him be holy still.
There will be no second chance. Now is the time to repent and get right with God and obey Him to the fullest and bear the fruits of a biblical child of God, a saint of God.
Here is the patience of the saints. Here are they that keep the commandments of God and the faith of Jesus.